classes. Now, today we are going to study scalar people product.
Important observations in
dot vector b cross vector c is scalar. Okay, this is scalar. Scalar means a number. That is clear because first bracket is there for these two vectors, vector b cross vector c. As a product, we are getting one vector here. So vector dot vector we are getting. So vector dot vector means it is a scalar. Therefore, scalar triple product is a scalar. As a product, we are getting a number. That is the first observation we can see. Then second observation. It is the geometrical meaning.
Vector.
that estimation is about. So this is vector A. This is vector A. We have to project that vector on vector B cross vector C. So to project means projection of one vector on another vector. That means here vector A is projected on vector B cross vector C. So vector A is projected on vector B cross vector C. That means projection of vector A on vector B cross vector C is given by vector A dot vector B cross vector C divided by second vector. Here we have written it as a magnitude of the vector, magnitude of vector B cross vector C. That is the projection of vector A on vector B is vector A dot vector B by magnitude of the vector B. Similar way, vector A is projected on vector B cross vector C. Therefore, projection is vector A dot vector B cross vector C by magnitude of vector B cross vector C. Therefore, this height, perpendicular height we require, that is vector A dot vector B cross vector C, then divided by magnitude of vector B cross vector C. Okay, you can see that this is the height. Magnitude of vector B cross C cancelled, as we have vector A dot vector B cross vector C is remaining now. Therefore, volume is equal to vector A dot vector B cross vector C. So therefore, I can write volume of parallel pipe, that is equal to vector A dot vector B cross vector C. So therefore, vector A, vector B, vector C are coterminal edges. You know, for example here, so I can take this box. Okay, this is one edge. That means one vector can be represented here. Another vector height that we represent here. Then another vector we can take here. That means four terminal edges. You can take this as the initial point. Then this is one vector and this is another vector and this is remaining vector. So in that way we can take in parallelogram also. Okay, that is about second observation. Volume of the parallel pipe is the geometrical mean of the scalar feature product. Okay, now let us write how to write vector A dot vector B cross vector C analytically. Okay, vector A is equal to A1 I cap, A2 J cap plus A3 K cap, and vector B, B1 I cap plus B2 J cap plus B3 K cap, and vector C, C1 I cap plus C2 J cap plus C3 K cap. Then we need to write vector A dot vector B cross vector C. So first let us write vector B cross vector C. To find the scalar feature product, first we have to find this. So vector B cross vector C, that means we have to take these two vectors. So cross product of the two vectors, that is given by the determinant. So determinant, first row I, J, K, and second row components of the vector B. Components of the vector B is B1, B2, B3. Third row component of the vector C, C1, C2, C3. Now take the determinant. The determinant is equal to I cap into sign associated plus minus plus. So taking determinant of first row, therefore we have B first row, first column. Then we have B2 C3 multiply B2 C3. Then I multiply upwards, then we have to take the minus sign, minus of B3 C2 or C2 B3. Then sign associated with the J cap is minus. So minus J cap into, now leave first row second column. We have B1 C3 minus C1 B3. Sign associated with the K cap is plus K cap into, leaving first row last column b1 c2 minus c1 b2. Thus we get this vector. Now vector A dot vector B cross vector C. So this is equal to what is vector A? So vector A is a1 i cap plus a2 j cap plus a3 k cap dot. Vector B cross vector C, that is this vector, that is b2 c3 minus c2 b3 into i cap, then minus b1 c3 minus c1 b3 into j cap plus b1 c2 minus c1 b2 into k cap. You know, taking dot product of these two vectors. So taking dot product means that is a component wise multiplication. Multiply, that is equal to here a1, and here we have component of the I cap, that is b2 c3 minus c2 b3. Then here we are having plus a2, and here we are having minus b1 c3 minus c1 b3. Therefore minus a2 into b1 c3 minus c1 b3. And here we are having a3, and here we are having b1 c2 minus c1 b2. a3 into b1 c2 minus c1 b2. Okay, now this is equal to, you can observe that vector b cross vector c in the place of i j k, now we are having a1 a2 a3. In the place of I cap, we are having a1, a2, a3. So that is the changes. So vector B cross vector C, that we can write it as a determinant. Similarly here, this answer, that we can write it as a determinant. In the place of I, J, K, a1, a2, a3 is there. Therefore here also, in the place of I, J, K, I have right a1, a2, a3. Then, so rest of the second row and third row, that is b1, b2, b3 and c1, c2, c3. Okay, therefore this is the representation of scalar triple product. So first vector, this is the vector A, that will comes in first row. That means vector A, you know that, can write box product of vector A dot vector B dot vector C, sorry, vector A, vector B, vector C is equal to determinant of A1, A2, A3, B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. So we write the box product equal to determinant of A1, A2, A3 in the first row, B1, B2, B3. Second row, C1, C2, C3 in the third row. Now, we can write in the using property of the determinant, we can interchange any two rows or any two columns, then new determinant after interchanging obtained is minus of the initial determinant. Therefore, that is equal to minus you will get if we interchange any two rows. Okay, now for that matter we can identify interchange second and first, then second row comes in first row, first row comes in second row. So we can write that is equal to, that will happen if I interchange R1 interchange with R2, first row and second row interchange, then I will obtain minus of, that is equal to B. Then second row will be A, vector A, then put the minus sign. So second row comes in first row. So it will be then first row appearing second row. So it will A. Third row as B. So it will C. So therefore we had to use minus. Also it is same as minus of. If we interchange second and third row, what happens? Second and third row means we are getting minus of third row, first row vector A, second row C, vector C we have written in second, third will be vector B. So that is also same as this. Also we can write minus of, we can write it as first and third we can interchange, then vector C, second will be vector B only, third will be vector A. Okay, if you interchange any two rows, then we get minus sign. So minus of the box product. That is one property in scalar triple product. Now what happens if we interchange two rows two times? So let us see that. That will be fifth property. Okay, I will interchange first row with the second row. First row with the second row, then I had to write minus sign. Now, second row interchange with the third row. Again, I will get minus sign. That means minus minus. Two times, then it will become plus. Therefore, box product of vector A, comma vector B, comma vector C, that is same as two times I interchange. So, I had to put here plus. Therefore, now we get. This is same as vector C that becomes the first row. That way we can write, or we can write vector B, then vector C, then vector A. So that is first row vector B comes, then second row C, third will be vector A. There is a cyclic permutation we are taking. So after A, then B should come, then C. A, B, C. B, C, A. C, A, B. In that way, cyclic permutation. So, box product of the cyclic permutations are equal. That means we interchange two rows, three rows here. Therefore, we are getting plus sign. So, this is same as, that is equal to, now I can write C, A, B also. It is same as C, A, B. So like this, so this is vector A, this is vector B, then this is vector C. So A, B, C, box product A, B, C. Then I can write B, C, A. Cyclic permutation, that is also same. Then I can write C, A, B. Again we get A, B, C, like that. So therefore cyclic permutation, box product of the cyclic permutations are equal. But if you interchange only two rows, then we are getting negative sign. So it is a fifth property in scalar triple product. Okay, now let us see sixth property. Now you can see that vector A, vector B, vector C. So these three vectors are lies on the same plane. Then vector A, vector B, vector C are coplanar. What happens at that time? So at that time, two possibilities are there. Now, suppose vector B and vector C are parallel. In this way, we get vector coplanar only. This is vector B and this is vector C. This will be the plane. Then these two vectors are parallel. We know that two vectors are parallel. Then their cross product equal to zero vector. Therefore, vector A B cross vector C is equal to zero vector. Then we can write vector A dot vector B cross vector C that is equal to zero vector. At that time, we get zero vector. Scalar tensor product is zero, or volume of the parallelepiped will be equal to zero. Now, if these two vectors are not parallel, means I can write like this: vector B, vector C, and vector A. You can see these three are coplanar now, and we are having one vector which is always perpendicular to vector B and vector C, which is vector B cross vector C. Now, so this is in one plane. Now this is perpendicular to that plane. So vector A perpendicular to vector B cross vector C. Vector A perpendicular to vector B cross vector C. Then dot product of two perpendicular vectors equal to zero. That means volume of the parallelepiped, which is equal to zero. Therefore, if three vectors are coplanar, vector A, vector B, vector C are coplanar, then volume of the parallelepiped, which is equal to zero. So converse also true, that happens. Therefore, we can write volume of parallelepiped is equal to zero. Now if I take four points, that is A, B, C, D. A, B, C, D. A, B, C are the four points, then I can write as a vector coplanar vectors, that is vector A, B, vector A, B, and I can write vector A, C, and I can write vector A, D. These are all comes in same plane. So A, B, C, D, four points are given. A, B, C, D, four points are given. Then you can prove coplanar, that is Gauss product of vector A, B, comma vector A, C, comma vector A, D, which is equal to zero. So A, B, C, D, four points are given. Then you can write it as a vector, that is vector A, B, vector A, C, vector A, D. If you take Gauss product, then it will be equal to zero. Or you can write A, B, A, B. Then coming to the one side, then you can write B, C also. A, B, B, C, C, D. In that way also we can write A, B, B, C, C, D. This will not require that. A, B, B, C, C. So Gauss product of A, B, vector A, B, vector B, C, and vector C, D, that is also equal to zero. So that is about the coplanarity. Next, okay, next one, sixth property or sixth observation in scalar triple product. Okay, that is dot and cross are interchangeable. Dot and cross are interchangeable. Okay, we have vector A dot, vector B cross, vector C. scalar and triple product, this expression that we can write easily. Therefore, vector C dot vector A cross vector B, which is same as vector A dot vector B cross vector C, already we have. Now, here we have to show that dot and cross are interchangeable. That means I can write this as vector A cross vector B dot vector C. From this to this, the change is because dot product is commutative. Dot product is commutative. I can write first vector into second vector same as second vector into first vector. That is commutative property. Okay, now look at the first and last step. So this is vector A dot vector B cross vector C. Now in the place of dot, we can see the cross. So like that. So dot and cross product, dot and cross can be interchangeable. That is the sixth observation or sixth property in scalar triple product. Now let us see the seventh one.
Then
we get scalar degree product equal to 0. So these are the properties of scalar triple product.
Coplanar.
So these three vectors are coplanar. component 1, minus 2, 3. Second row, minus 2, 3, minus 4. And third row, we have 1, minus 3, 5. Add to get the answer, which is equal to 0. Now, this is equal to, take the determinant, sign associated for the first row, plus minus plus, plus 1, 1. Now, delete first column and first row, 3 into 5, 15, then minus 3 into minus 4, 12, minus of 12, then minus into minus 2, plus 2, delete first row, second column, first row, second column, minus 2 into 5, minus 10, then 1 into minus 4, that is equal to plus 4, minus of plus 4, minus 4. That is equal to, plus 4, that is minus 4, already we have minus 10, already we have minus 4, minus of minus 4, that is equal to plus 4 here. Plus 3, that is sign associated for the first row, this last element, plus 3, deleting first row, last column. So we have minus 2 into minus 3. 6 plus 6. Then minus of 1 into 3, 3. So this is equal to 15 minus 12. 3 plus 2 into minus 6 plus 3 into 3. So answer is 3 minus 12 plus 9. That is equal to 12 minus 12, 0. So therefore thus, I have to show box product equal to 0 and I got answer 0. That means vector A, comma vector B and vector C are collinear. So these three vectors are collinear. That is the second one.
Minus 1
and let us see lambda, that is 7 3, lambda 7 3, this is equal to 0. Okay, take the determinant and get the value of the lambda. Okay, sign associated to the first row, plus, minus, plus. So this is equal to, determinant equal to 1 plus 1, deleting first row, first column, minus 1 into 3, minus 3, plus 7, minus 3, here we get minus 7, so minus of minus 7, plus 7. Then sign associated for the 3, that is minus, so minus 3, deleting first row, second column, we have 2 into 3, 6, then lambda into minus 1, that is equal to minus lambda, but minus of minus lambda plus lambda. Then sign associated for the last element, plus 1, deleting first row, last column, first row, last column, 2 into 7, 14, then lambda into minus 1, minus lambda, minus of minus plus lambda, so that is equal to 0, determinant value already, that is equal to 0. Okay, now, this is equal to 7 minus 3, 4, minus 3 into 6, minus 18, minus 3 lambda, plus 14, plus lambda equal to 0. Okay, that is equal to, here we have minus 14, then minus 14, plus 14, I am adding numbers, minus 3 lambda plus lambda, minus 2 lambda equal to 0. So minus 14 plus 14, 0, so 0 is equal to 2 lambda, that implies lambda equal to 0. So answer is, value of the lambda equal to 0. So 3 vectors are open, are given, then you can find the value of lambda.
Plus I cap plus J cap plus K cap.
are given, and here given that we have to show coplanar. That means cross product of three vectors equal to zero. Okay, let me take A, B, C, D as A. I can write as the position vector, vector OA. In that way, I can write, or just write end point as A. A means position vector, that is 4i cap plus 5j cap plus k cap. I can write 4, 5, 1. 4, 5, 1. Or different also I can write, or 4i cap, in that way also I can write. Now let us write B. That is the second vector. B, that is equal to minus 1. Sorry, 0, there is no I cap. So 0, minus 1, minus 1. Minus A, minus B. So minus 1, minus 1. C, 3, comma 9, comma 4. 3, comma 9, comma 4. And D, that is equal to minus 4, minus 4, plus 4, plus 4. So in this way we can write A, B, C, D. These are the terminal points. Or as a vector also you can write. Now we have to show that 4 point A, B, C, D, that means I can write it as a vector, vector A, B. So vector A, B is vector O, B minus vector O, A. In that way also we can write. Or just subtract second point to first point. That is, we can write terminal minus initial. That is equal to 0 minus 4. Minus 4, minus 1, minus 5, minus 6, minus 1, minus 1, minus 2. Vector A. Or you can write it as minus 4 I cap, minus 6 j cap, minus 2 k cap. That way also you can write. Okay, now vector AB and vector AC, initial point same, then I can write AB, AC, AD. I am going to write AB, AC, AD. So what is vector AC? Vector AC means subtract terminal point and terminal point minus initial point. So 3 minus 4, minus 1, 9 minus 5, 4, then 4 minus 1, 3. Minus 1, 4, 3. Vector AD. So vector AD is equal to, that is minus 4, minus 4, minus 8, then 4 minus 5, minus 1, 4 minus 1, 3. So vector AB, AC, AD. So we get AB, AC, AD. You know Gauss product of vector AB, comma vector AC, comma vector AD, that is equal to determinant of, first we have to write the vector AB, minus 4, minus 6, minus 2. Vector AC, minus 1, 4, 3. Vector AD, minus 8, minus 1, 3. Write me the answer. Coplanar I have to show. I have to get the determinant equal to 0. So that is equal to, now this is equal to sine for the first row plus minus plus. Okay, minus 4 into plus, that is equal to minus 4 only. Deleting first row, first column, 4 into 3, 12. Minus of minus 3, plus 3. Minus of minus 6, plus 6, deleting first and second, first row, second column, minus 3, minus 24. 60 plus 126 minus 66. That is equal to minus 60 minus 66 minus 126 plus 126. That is equal to 0. Okay, thus given determinant equal to 0 means vector AB, vector AC, vector AD. That is 3 vectors formed by AB, CD, 4 points are collinear. So this is about 4th one. Now, so question number 5. Okay, question number 5. Second vector cross third vector. So first we have to find then multiply vector b to vector a plus vector b cross vector a plus now vector c to vector c vector c cross vector c plus vector c to vector a vector c cross vector a. Okay, now here you know that vector c cross vector c equal vector cross product is always equal to zero vector. So that means this is zero vector. So we have only three vectors. So vector b cross vector c plus vector b cross vector a and vector c cross vector a. Okay, now multiply. This is equal to now first vector multiply to these three vectors. Then second vector multiply to these three vectors. So therefore vector a multiplication is the dot. So vector a dot vector b cross vector c. Then plus vector a multiply to the second, that is vector a dot vector b cross vector a. Now vector a is multiplied to the last vector, multiplied to the last, plus vector a dot vector c cross vector a. Now similar way, second vector multiplied to the first vector plus vector b dot vector b cross vector c plus vector b is now multiplied to the second vector vector b dot vector b cross vector a plus vector b dot, so vector b is multiplied to the last vector now, vector b dot vector c cross vector a. So thus we get, so first vector first one vector a dot vector b cross vector c, then I will write it as a cross product of vector a b c. Then about the second one, so out of three vectors two vectors are same, so this is equal to zero from property of scalar-typical product or from the observation this is equal to zero. And in the next one vector a dot vector c cross vector a vector a, therefore this is also equal to zero. And in the third vector b dot vector b cross vector c, so vector b is there two times, so this is also equal to zero. And fourth one vector b dot vector b cross vector a, so this is also equal to zero. Last one vector b dot vector c cross vector a, so three vectors are different, so vector b dot vector c cross a I can write it as first vector b cross product of vector b, second vector c b comma c comma a. Now this is equal to box product of vector a vector b vector c plus I can write this box product as vector a comma vector b vector c, because cyclic commutation b c a which is same as a b c. Now you can see that two times the same box product, so 2 into box product of vector a comma vector b comma vector c, that is equal to right hand side what we have to do. So now we put this. Here is the answer. We put the RHS. box product of vector a comma vector b comma vector c plus vector d according to the notation. I can write first vector dot second vector cross third vector. Okay, now this is equal to vector a dot multiply. Here we get vector b cross vector c as one vector plus vector b cross vector d by distributive property in cross product. Now this is equal to multiply vector a dot vector b cross vector c plus, now vector a is multiplied to the second, vector a dot vector b cross vector d. Okay, now this is equal to box product of first vector vector a, second vector vector b, third vector vector c plus vector a, second vector vector b, third vector d. Okay, the same as right side RHS. So LHS is equal to RHS.
Vector C,